Returning to my hometown on the banks of the Yalu, the river that separates China from North Korea, I find it changed beyond recognition. It is as if all traces of the small town I grew up in have been erased and replaced by rows of faceless new high-rises. Only the waters of the Yalu River remain unchanged. That symbol of Sino-North Korean friendship, the iron bridge meant to link both sides, still spans the river much as I remember it. On the opposite bank, North Korean children are playing, immersed in the same games along the same river, the same carefree days I remember from my own childhood. I still recall clearly that as our boat used to approach the shore, women washing clothes and children playing by the riverbank would always stop what they were doing to give us a smile or a friendly wave. Their beaming faces made me especially conscious of the friendship that existed between our two countries and of our special relationship as comrades and brothers. But reality has taken a strange and unexpected turn. Now, instead of smiles, there are covered faces. Children who once waved to us have now turned to throwing rocks. And there are the heavily armed soldiers, border police, who patrol the river's edge. They are a powerful reminder that attitudes have changed. Piercing through the dense fog, treading on broken shards of memory, I travel along this river, wandering back and forth on the very border of socialism. I want to see with my own eyes what is happening to this nation of people who once cherished a beautiful dream. This narrow stretch of river is like a wall in time, partitioning the same space into two different eras. I gaze in silence at the people on the opposite bank as they go about their chores, leading their quiet lives as if the world around them did not exist. Each scene evokes a strong sense of déjà vu, as if I were eavesdropping on my own memories. Standing on the riverbank, observing the current state of socialism, and thinking back on its history, I cannot help but feel hopeless.
你看这么好的牙裤毛裤 真的是，哼，这是不正常的。
对。
这上面是这些朝鲜人什么东西？
东西啊，
嗯，
东西没看着，刚看着他们那个路过前点的小火堆儿，那个有，
还有火堆呢。
啊，就是点完之后剩的那些柴火。嗯，
我看那河边好多掉脱下来的衣服。
是，那都是他们的。
那他们那他们脱那衣服，他们穿什么？
他是在咱那边拿的衣服，把他的衣服脱下来了，那是他们的衣服。
啊，对呀，扔那儿。
啊，扔了那就是。
那他们没他们到这儿上哪儿找衣服穿？
他在偷啊！哎，去年村里偷的。哎，秋天是春天的，
春天
开春儿。嗯，自家的小自保里头抓的一个小逼崽子。啊，前小疙瘩我都不高，就这么高，嗯，小孩
抓的都是小孩，抓不着那么大的。
都进家偷去了。再过几天村里就该遭殃了，村里该偷了。
是，冬天的时候。
哎呀，他们有时候他们边防也过来偷。
过来偷？
偷，啥不偷啊？
啊，边防来偷老百姓。
来偷。
Looking at the quiet waters and the piles of clothing at the river's edge, it is hard to imagine how anyone could make up phrases like illegal immigration or defection at the sight of such an ordinary looking piece of land. In my memory, we and our neighbors across the river were linked by a shared idealism. What links us now is that most primitive form of commerce, barter trades and goods. It has become a regular fact of daily life on both sides of the river. Where the river is widest, boats are used. In places where the river is narrower, goods are simply dragged across in this way. In exchange for daily commodities from China, the North Koreans trade copper, iron, and other metals.